Hello, how to defeat the Soviet Union? Some player struggles a little bit with this topic. Now I tell how I did it in my Let's Play. First, you need a lot of troops. It sounds simple, but it's the truth. Not a lot of tanks, not a lot of simple divisions. Like this, for example. There are a lot of... That's not... Yep. And here a lot of these divisions, because you have a long front line and you need some units to cover that. The most people build some tanks, but you need a lot of divisions to cover the front. Tanks, for example, here are some and here are some. They make a breakthrough and castle encirclement. In German we call this a castle schlacht. And encircle the enemy, but you also need these troops to protect the castle. You need to cover your flanks. One Rommel citat is that the best flank protection is the confusion on the enemy, but it's not work in this game because enemy see exactly what you're doing, and that's not work. So you need a lot of troops to cover it. That's the most important thing. The most thing most people have, in my opinion, did wrong. Lot of troops. The second new thing are these railway guns. They are very cheap. And then they can support all troops in this area. This is a little bit too close. This is a little bit too close. But I assigned some to my armies because I don't like to micro everything. And so they move with the army, and so you have always support. The other thing is, which part are the valuable parts of the Soviet Union? One player tell he tries always to circle here in the north, but there are these forests, and your tanks are bad, just bad in this forest. So and there are not much factories. The most most valuable part for Germany is the oil and the factories on the way. And here are all open plain and easy, very easy terrain. We have also these rivers here. And if you push here, you can make a very big line here down, and the enemy can't attack, can't retreat around back because there's the river and your troops protect the river and they can't attack across the river. And same situation, same idea here. Can push around here. This is unpassable, this area, and the enemy can't move back because your troops protect on the wrong side of the river, so for them, and they can't go back, or you can easily encircle here a large part of the enemy unit. You can also later, if you this area is connected, this port, deploy ships here, some small destroyers or small submarines, and you gain navy superiority, and you can even make navy invasions here. So, some ideas to template. You need this is a little bit too small. Tanks are for the planes, and the planes are have a combat width of 30 of 90, and so you would build them. Combat width of 30. I did this for this unit. You don't need much armor against the AI always. The AI build a lot of infantry, but they don't... and then that's enough armor. Especially, I don't know why, but the Soviet Union in this gameplay don't use any anti-tank gun. British troops or some other troops use it, but if they don't have any anti-tank gun, even 10 armor with this flamethrower tank is enough. And this flamethrower tank helps also to attack across rivers. The second engineer tech help also to attack. Only against fortifications useful. The third is useful across rivers. So this is very important tech. Something a lot of people don't use is the Air Force that much. You need the Air Force not only to fight enemy planes, not only to make the air green air, like, but every plane, every fighter who flies more make the enemy weaker and the enemy slower. And it's much easier to encircle the enemy if the enemy is slower. A lot of people say, oh, I need more speed, but if the enemy run away with 2 kilometers an hour, you don't need that much speed. Something I don't use could be cavalry, could be useful too. And the Air Force in general, because they have now here in the back line, they need the supplies in this area, not in the front line. You can take, you have not a lot of supplies in the front, but the Air Force can give you firepower on the front line without using the supplies from the front line. Complicated thinking, but that's the idea. You can always use the supply, but that's not very useful. This for example, this unit use 2.1. And if I move with this unit, use 2.7, that's a half infantry division more supply, 1.50. And infantry use 1 supply or a little bit less, depending on how big it is. But these divisions don't gain a lot of supply by using the supply company. This game, I don't know this, but they are not very useful. Better use the for example, the field hospital, not for manpower, but if they gain experience, units are much more powerful. That's the idea. You can also, especially if the enemy use some anti-aircraft, sign your fighters to to your tank units, for example. For example, here to Guderian, they are the unit who make the breakthrough, and they need much firepower as possible, but not every infantry fight needs air support, especially if the enemy have a lot of anti-aircraft, or if you have less fighter bombers, less close air support. If the enemy don't have anti-air, just bomb everything. Spies can be very useful. If you don't have a collaboration government in the Soviet Union, you need to conquer the big cities, of course, and to the Ural, slightly behind the Ural. If the Japanese somehow conquer Vladivostok, that's very useful, but in the normal gameplay they don't do it. So collaboration government is very useful because you don't have to move this far. But if you conquer the 3 big cities, the enemy is defeated anyway, but you have to push them a very long area. Something. Yes, of course. A lot of people build big tanks, but that's not a big problem. For example, this I built this Stuck. This Sturmgeschütz in German, assault gun, first was used to support infantry in a support artillery. And converted then to a tank hunter somehow. But you need a lot of soft attack against infantry because the enemy mostly build infantry. Genau. The most units or enemy units on the world are always infantry. The soft attack is more important than the hard attack. And some armor is very useful, but you don't need that much. You can build very heavy armored units, but I never build heavy tanks, so you don't need them. This game, the Soviet Union don't use any AT gun, so you don't need that much armor. If they use AT guns, you can look what they do, how powerful they are, and adapt a little bit. The new supply system that's the next important topic, I forgot. Makes the conquering the Soviet Union much more difficult, or any conquering, because you must jump from supply hub to supply hub. Don't go in this swamp. If possible, it's just killing all your equipment. Especially don't use tanks in this area. For example, before you do anything, look at a supply map and where the supply hubs are. And then jump from one, then you have to conquer this, or probably make some encirclement here and conquer this, and then you have conquered this, and then you conquer this, and always you need time to convert the railway, then your supply is here, then you can move there, and this is a very big area. But that's the way it works. You can't just move around the area. You need the supply hubs. That's another reason why this is very interesting. You can push here, conquer this supply hub, and then go around this line and conquer the next supply hub here. I don't know really what's that. Egal. And you can also use paratroopers to drop on the enemy railway or the enemy supply hub and cut them off. For example, if you put one paratrooper here, and one here, all this area here is cut off. They have still a connection, they can still run away, but they have no supply. And then you can easily kill them and make a real encirclement. I can put some paratrooper here that the enemy don't dig in on the other side of the river. Can make, for example, I have. There's my paratroopers. That's the problem. Don't see the supply map. So you must recognize where the supply hubs are. But they are in this. You see the railway. That's very. You know what I mean. And then they just cut off the enemy. And they are still there. They can. Easy away, because all over are your paratroopers, and if you conquer this area, then later the train line is converted then, and you can easily move up. So for example, like that. And even in multiplayer, this could be a good idea, because no one can put all over the map units to defend all the railways. So that's the idea. Can also do navy invasions in Leningrad, for example, if you like to do that. The Black Sea, they're the Soviet fleet, but you can deploy some ships here and try to kill them or try to kill them with the air force. Yeah, that's my plans to kill the Soviet Union. The first time with the new DLC, I think it don't work. The second time it works. It's a little bit try. So, thank you for listening. Bye.